Yo, what's good, family? It's your boy D Cook on location. And real quick, I'm gonna go ahead and address this Gucci issue one time, just one time, because I told myself that I wasn't. And reason being that, and this is just for me, but personally, I just feel as though they're just symptoms to the bigger problem that we have. They're just a diversion stopping us from getting to the solution of the problems that we're seeing. And personally, you know, as a black man, I'm so tired of being disrespected. You know, by whoever, Gucci, whoever. I'm just tired of that. I'm tired of that right there, you know. But I understand that the elephant in the room ain't Gucci. It ain't all these other diversions that's coming. It's the fact that slavery was real and mass incarceration school, the prison pipeline is real and racism is real. Those things are real. And those are things that we got to address. And once we address those things and get those right, Gucci and everybody else will fall in line. But I just can't keep chasing my tail around in the circle, you know, waiting for things to get better. You're going to send me after Gucci right now. We're going to stand on that until that fade out. Then what? Before that, it was H&M. When I was growing up, it was Get Used by Eli. And this is going to be something different tomorrow. That's why I love, you know, organizations like NEC, UNIA, Nation of Islam. Because they're telling you right now, fam, you got to go out and take care of yourself. Listen, family. Black brothers and sisters, you can't wean your way off of oppression. This ain't the methadone clinic, right? You don't come in and get 100 mLs today, the next week you come in and get 80, and then, you know, you break down to 60. And in most cases, both of those got similarities anyway, because people that go to the methadone clinic usually end up staying there for life. And people that have been mistreated the way we have and have been enslaved, if it was left up to the oppressor, you will stay there for life. I'm trying to get you off of that, family. I'm trying to get us off of that. I'm trying to get us off of that. So you just can't wean your way off of that. You don't break down. You got to stop that cold turkey. Listen, if you know you being oppressed, if you know you are being oppressed, you can't continue to put money into the kitty that is helping to oppress you. That don't make sense at all. Do it. And this ain't no disrespect to nobody else that's watching. This ain't no disrespect to nobody. But you know what's going on in this country and you know what's happening. And if you was in opposition, you would be out here fighting the same way that we doing now. That's if you wanted your freedom. So I'm saying to my brothers and sisters, you got to stand up. You got to stand up and you got to think. And you got to start shopping with your own and stop spending these bags out here to go buy this Gucci, to go buy, you know, H&M, Louis Vuitton. All that stuff is irrelevant. And it's harming our community. Every time an artist come out here, a rapper come out here and spit that, you know, we even got an artist that got his name after that company. What we going to do about that? What we going to do about that? So we can't come out here and tell our youth to go out here and buy Gucci, go out here and buy Louis Vuitton, you know, and send them off. You sending us off, bro. You sending us off. And I'm so thankful as an MC, I never was a fashion whore. I never rapped about all that stuff. I rapped about me, myself, and I. That's where I come from. Shout out to all the real MCs. And shout out to all the conscious people out there. But if you want to get yourself out this situation, if we want to get ourselves out of this situation, it can't be by going one step at a time and weaning our way off. Because after we finish fighting Gucci, it's going to be somebody else to fight. I'm saying cut it off at the root. And don't invest in any of it. And I promise you, we'll get to our solution faster. All right? That's what it is, family. Y'all already know what's up. Holla. Peace.